Yesterday evening, Sonia and her younger brother Pavan were discussing about living beings and their ability of adaptation. Today, when they were playing, many questions crossed Sonia's mind. She thought that why don't continue the discussion with Pavan and their mother?
Mother, yesterday, Pavan and I were discussing about the adaptive capability of animals according to the environment. Regarding this, we discussed a lot about plants and animals. But I have a question in my mind. Plants are stationary, but the animals move here to there. Similarly, many non-living objects stay affixed at a place, but others are not, like air and water.
Yes, you are right. But what is your question, Sonia?
I am thinking that which are those things which differentiate living things from non-living things?
It is an interesting question. Some things are easier to comprehend. For example, how living organisms grow. We are so small at the time of birth and gradually grow and become adults. Animals like birds and reptiles lay eggs, from which their babies come out. Then they grow and become adults.
But mother, all these signs are shown by plants as well. I can understand one thing, that all living organisms consume food, from which they get nutrients and energy.
Yes, children, it proves that even plants are living beings. And in fact, plants are the primary sources of food, as they make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. Other animals depend on them for their food, either directly or indirectly.
Sonia, one more thing. The organisms consume food out of which a part of food which is unused by the body is excreted by them in the form of urine and stool. All the organisms do this.
What? But I have never seen plants excreting urine or stool.
Trees and plants excrete their waste material in a different manner. Their waste materials get accumulated in some of their parts, like leaves and bark. When too much waste gets accumulated, the trees shed their leaves and barks.
Oh! It means that all the animals consume food and excrete.
Sonia, yesterday, were we not trying to hold our breath underwater? All living beings breathe too, and that too in different ways.
Yes, we learned that the terrestrial animals breathe through the nostrils, whereas fishes breathe through gills, and dolphins breathe through a hole on their head. Some other animals breathe through their skin as well, like earthworms.
And some animals, like frogs, can breathe both in water and on land. In water, they breathe through their skin, and on land, they breathe through their nostrils.
Yes, and isn't it interesting that plants breathe differently in days and nights? During the day, through the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is generated. They use the oxygen according to their need and release the rest in the atmosphere. On the other hand, after sunset, plants are unable to perform photosynthesis and start taking oxygen in and release carbon dioxide.
All this is so amazing, right? There are so many unbelievable animals in this world, possessing variations among them.
Yes, you are right. But along with these variations, they share many similarities as well. Like, animals can adapt as per their habitat. They respire, consume food, and excrete. Some animals walk and jump as per their will. And there is one more task performed by all living beings.
What is that?
That is reproduction. It is the process through which animals multiply. Some organisms lay eggs and some give birth to their young ones.
Yes, even plants reproduce through seeds. Even the roots and stems of some plants have the capability to reproduce. It is just that the plants can't move.
Movement is one of the many characteristics possessed by living beings. But movement only doesn't justify their liveliness. Other abilities like breathing, reproduction should also be present to qualify as a living being.
For example, my remote controlled car. That is why air and water are still classified as non-living, even when they can move. What a way of explaining. Thanks, mummy.
Really, there is so much variation in the world. We have discussed about only a few animals. In forests, water bodies, deserts, and grasslands, there are so many animals about which we don't even know. And there are so many microorganisms that live in our surrounding air, soil, the food we eat, and even within ourselves in our body.
Yes, and the qualities we have discussed now taught us about how living beings are different from non-living beings.
This is so interesting. In the coming summer vacation, we should visit somewhere where we can observe a lot of amazing animals.
That is why I have thought that we should visit rainforests of Kerala this summer vacation.
Yay! This is great idea, since yesterday I was also thinking about the same, that where should we visit. I like this plan too. We will find many amazing animals in the rainforest.
Wow, we are going to enjoy a lot then. We will definitely go to Kerala.